The Amazon forests are burning at a record-breaking pace, sparking serious concerns around the world. The source? They are mainly being set by ranchers and farmers clearing the land for cultivation. With the support of the Pulitzer Center, Amna Nawaz and producer Mike Fritz recently trekked deep into Brazil to witness what is driving this deforestation. It's part of our ongoing series, Brazil on the Brink.
It's an environmental treasure stretching across more than 2 million square miles, about 60% of which is here in Brazil. But the Amazon, the world's largest rainforest and a vital line of defense in the fight against climate change, is under assault.
This was entirely forest 30 or 40 years ago.
Mike Coe is a scientist at the Woods Hole Research Center in Mato Grosso, Brazil. He's been studying and visiting the Amazon for 20 years. These trees, he says, are crucial not just for how much carbon dioxide they absorb, but also for the role they play in cooling the planet.
Tropical forests take up something like a quarter of all what humans put in the atmosphere. They're basically a giant air conditioner. They are incredibly efficient at taking in sunlight and water and putting it back in the atmosphere, and that leads to cooling.
Since the 1970s, the Amazon has been steadily deforested. Nearly 20% has already been wiped out. And this year, the region has seen record-breaking forest fires. Nearly 60,000 fires have engulfed vast sections of the Brazilian Amazon. The effects, Coe says, are clear.
What we end up with is, out here, it's about 10 degrees warmer on average throughout the year than it is inside the forest. And that's
10 degrees warmer out here in the deforested areas.
Yeah, absolutely.
Than it is where the trees are.
Absolutely.
The driving force behind the decline of the Amazon in Brazil? The rise of the country's booming agribusiness sector.
So unlike most of Brazil's economy, agriculture has actually been growing. It's been growing steadily over the last few years, fueled mostly by soy and cotton and corn crops like these. But critics say that that growth in the agricultural industry has come at the expense of the Amazon.
In fact, an estimated 80% of the deforestation in the Brazilian Amazon is due to agriculture, a result of decades of permissive land use policies that transformed huge swaths of this region into cheap farm acreage.
The agricultural sector has always been a major player in Brazilian politics, going back to before even the proclamation of the Republic.
Monica Debol is a Latin American expert at the Peterson Institute of International Economics. She says since the 1960s, Brazil has grown into an agricultural giant, now the world's leading exporter of beef, chicken, and soybeans.
There's a lot of political influence there. There's also a lot of economic power, because the agribusiness sector is the one bright spot in the Brazilian economy right now.
While GDP in Brazil has remained sluggish in recent years, growing by only 1% annually, agriculture has steadily risen by as much as 13% in 2017. And while deforestation in the Amazon slowed from 2004 to 2012, it's picked back up over the last few years as new roads and infrastructure push development further into once remote areas. In January, a new threat to the Amazon came with the inauguration of President Jair Bolsonaro, a climate change denier. He has repeatedly pledged to open up more of the rainforest for business.
Let's use the riches that God gave us for the well-being of our population.
The government hasn't understood yet the risks of the increase in deforestation for the reputation of Brazil, for our markets, and for our future.
André Guimarães is the executive director of the Amazon Environment Research Institute. Further destruction of the Amazon, he says, is their chief concern.
The entire world is trying to find the right way to promote our human activities in an environment with an increase in temperature globally. And the Amazon plays a central role in storing carbon. So it's crucial maintaining the Amazon for the stabilization of the climate globally.
It's important to point out that not all deforestation is illegal. Under Brazilian law, farmers and ranchers can cut down up to 20% of trees like this on their own land if they need to. The problem, scientists say, is that the Bolsonaro government has rolled back inspections and monitoring and fines. They've basically made it harder to enforce the law.
Since President Bolsonaro took office in January, roughly 1,000 square miles of forest has been lost, a nearly 40% increase from last year. Back in Mato Grosso, Coe and his colleagues are trying to understand the effects of all that destruction. measuring and monitoring, tracking trends in a shifting environment.
An average year today is like an extremely hot, dry year 30 years ago. So the climate has changed drastically because of deforestation and because of just the general climate change.
Coe says they're studying what happens when forest becomes farmland, in this case, a soybean field.
What it's really doing is measuring how conductive the soil is. And the more water there is, the more conductive it is.
Why is that important?
Because for the first time, we can get a picture of how much water there actually is. So out in the soybean field, there's a lot more water in the soil. The rain comes in, it all goes into the soil. The trees use a great deal of it. The soybeans really don't.
Yeah.
Because for 9 months out of the year, they're really not doing anything. So that sits in the soil, and then it goes into the streams and just gets flushed out to the ocean.
As Coe explains, with fewer trees, less water actually goes back into the atmosphere after rainfall, which in turn leads to shorter rainy seasons and more frequent droughts.
So the trees are responsible for pushing a lot of that water back up into the atmosphere, leading to more of the rain. You've got less rain here now, too, right? What
Correct.
Does that mean?
The dry season is something like 5 months long. So already, by the end of the dry season, they're running out of water. You know, they're using what's left in the soil, and they're running out. And so you push another 2 weeks, that's a lot more stress on the forest. Same issue. The forest that remains is just under more stress. More of it dies.
This is just one of many multi-year projects being done by Coe and his team at Tanguro Ranch, a sprawling 200,000-acre industrial farm that sits at the very edge of the southern Amazon. Soybeans, corn, and cotton are all grown here, but it's also a research lab to understand exactly the impact left behind. It's a rare partnership between agribusiness and the scientific community that dates back to 2004, when a few agricultural leaders in Brazil realized a balance between growth and conservation was needed. Divino Silverio is a scientist on that team. Often tasked with climbing high above the tree line, Silverio tracks exactly what's being lost from deforestation.
So I am here in this tower, and it allows us to measure how much carbon that this forest is assimilating or emitting into the atmosphere.
Born and raised in the area, Silverio is the son of subsistence farmers.
It was natural for us to transform nature, to cut down the forest. That was normal for me. But what I learned in school helped me have a better understanding of the consequences. And it's important to emphasize that agriculture is important to everyone. We have to produce food. But at the same time, it's also important to preserve nature as it is.
Safeguarding the forest doesn't have to come at the expense of agricultural development, according to Mercedes Bustamante, a biologist and professor at the University of Brasilia.
The economic activity that needs more environmental protection is agriculture itself, because you need water, you need good soils, we need pollinators, we need pest control, you need a very stable climate.
You're saying it could actually be better yes. for agribusiness yes. if conservation yes. were put first.
Yes, and actually, if you see the land use in Brazil, we still have available land mm-hmm. for the agriculture development mm-hmm. and also for conservation.
The future of the Amazon now depends on finding this balance, says Thomas Lovejoy, an ecologist who studied the rainforest since the 1960s.
We're seeing, I think, the first flickerings of the tipping point with historic droughts in 2005, 2010, and 2016.
If that tipping point is reached, which Lovejoy believes could happen if more than 20 to 25% of the Amazon is destroyed, it would be devastating to the region's ecosystem, creating hotter, drier weather patterns that will transform large sections of the jungle into a savanna.
You can go down in history as being the equivalent of the person who created the Dust Bowl in the United States. The difference is between the Dust Bowl and the situation is in the Amazon and in Brazil, is we actually scientifically understand what's going on and can avoid those tipping points.
And for scientists like Divino Silverio, avoiding that tipping point is not only crucial for the Amazon, but also for a place he has long called home.
It's where I grew up, where my family lives. To me, this region is part of me. It's also special because of its extraordinary diversity, which has always been part of my life. So there's an intense feeling of loss when we see the changes that are happening.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Amna Navaz in Mato Grosso, Brazil.
And tomorrow, our series Brazil on the Brink examines the threats faced by animals that call the Amazon home and potential solutions that will protect them.